Hello everybody and welcome back on my channel. My name is Alex and today in this tutorial I'm gonna show you how to make this belt tightener in SolidWorks. And for this we'll be following the next drawing. We've got this picture from the internet. And here are all the components with all the dimensions. And for this wood roof key, I don't know the exact dimensions, so I'm gonna use my dimensions, but if you do know the exact dimensions for this, you can use them. So let's begin. We'll start with this bracket, then we'll make this frame, then we'll make the pulley, the shaft, and then the other small components. Let's begin. First we'll open a new part. Here we'll make plain white. And now we'll start a sketch in the top plane. Here we'll start with two circles. Actually, let's start with a center line. Let's make a center line like this, vertically, then select dynamic mirror entities command, select this center line. And now we'll select circle. We'll make here one. And then we'll make a center point arc. Just like this, and then select line and make these two lines, and then we'll have to make on this side the same. Okay, now select this point, select here, make tangent, select this one, make here tangent. Now we can close this, and now we'll select smart dimension to define this sketch. Between these two points, here will be 76 millimeters. Okay, here the radius will be 12 millimeters. Here this dimension will be 32 millimeters. Okay, select these two lines and make them equal. And now the dimension between these two lines. Here will be 70 millimeters. Okay, now make these two equal. Nice, and now we'll have to see. Okay, so now select these two points and select here, make horizontal. Nice, and this small circle will have the diameter 12.5 millimeters. Now go to features, use extruded boss base command, and here the thickness will be 12. Press OK. And now we'll open a sketch on this face, normal tool, and here we'll select line. We'll start with line from this. Just like this, and here make a tangent arc. Okay, and select this line and make it vertical. And now we'll select smart dimension and we'll give here, actually no, from this point to this edge, here will be 32 millimeters. And now we'll select circle, we'll make here a circle. This circle will have the diameter 10 millimeters. And now go to features and use extruded boss base command. We'll select here reverse direction and the thickness will be 12 millimeters. Press OK. Nice. Now we'll have to make thread inside this hole. So we'll go to hole wizard, click on this arrow, select from there thread. Here we'll have to select the thread location, the start point, the start edge, which is this edge. Okay, we'll select here offset, the offset will be 2 millimeters. And here we'll select, we can select up to selection. And we'll select this edge. We'll have to select here at the offset to reverse the direction. Here we'll select metric tab and the size will be M12 and the pitch 1.75. So we'll have to find here M12 and the pitch 1.75. Select it. And now here we'll have to select cut thread. Press OK. And now we have the thread for this hole. Nice, now we'll have to use mirror to mirror this on this other side. So we'll select front plane, we'll select here mirror, and then add features to mirror. We'll go to this arrow, first we'll select boss extruded 2, press OK, and then we'll use mirror again. We'll select front plane, and then we'll select thread, and we'll select here geometry pattern, and press OK. Nice, and now we'll have to apply some fillets to these edges. So select fillet command. Here the radius will be 3 mm, and we'll have to select this one with this one, and then this one with this one, and press here OK. And now for the second fillet will be the same radius. We'll select this edge with this one and press OK. Nice, and now the bracket is done. We'll have to save it. So save it. I'll save it on my desktop. Bracket. Okay, now we'll have to make the next part, which is the frame. So open a new part. And here let's make also plain white. And now we'll open a sketch in the front plane. Sketch, and here we'll make two circles, one in this center point and one somewhere here. And now we'll select smart dimension to define this sketch. So first this circle will have the diameter 48 mm, and this one will have the diameter 32 mm. Okay, and the dimension between them will be 140 mm. And now to fully define this one, select these two points and select here make vertical. Now go to features and use extruded boss base command. We'll go to selected contours, and here we'll select only the big one first, and the thickness will be 25 mm. 25, press here OK. And now we'll go to extruded boss base command again, click on this arrow, go to boss extruded 1, select sketch 1, go to selected contours, delete this, and we'll have to select the small circle. This time the thickness will be 19 mm, and press OK. Nice, now we'll have to create another plane in the middle of this small cylinder. So go to reference geometry, select from here plane. For the first reference we'll select top plane, and here the distance will be 140 mm, and we'll select here flip offset. And now we have the plane in the middle of this cylinder. Press here OK. And now we'll open a sketch in the top plane. Okay, and here we'll select ellipse command, and we'll make here an ellipse just like this. And now we'll have to define this. So between these two points here will be 12 mm, and now select these two points, make them horizontal, and then select this point with this edge. So this edge with this point, select here coincide, and do the same for this one. So the point with the edge coincide. Nice, and now we'll have to select smart dimension again, and the dimension from this point to this point here will be 3 mm. Nice, now we'll have to exit this sketch and we'll select plane 1. We'll open a sketch, select this sketch, select here normal 2 again. So you'll have to see this small cylinder. And now we'll select ellipse again. We'll start from this point this time until this point. Okay. Maybe not until this point. Delete this coincide here. And now select these two points and make them horizontal. And now it's my dimension. We'll give a dimension between these two points and will be also 12. Okay, now let's see. Now we'll have to select this point and this edge and we'll have to make them to coincide. So select here coincide. And now this is also fully defined. Exit this sketch. And now right click on this plane, select here hide. And now we'll have to use lofted boss base command. Select it, and here we'll have to select this profile and with this one. Press here OK. Nice. Now we'll have to mirror this on this other side, but first we'll have to make another plane. So go to reference, select plane. For the first reference we'll select front plane. We'll have to change here the direction, so select here flip offset, and the distance will be 35 millimeters. Press OK. And now we'll have to use mirror, and here the plane will be plane 2. And we'll go to bodies to mirror and we'll select this body. Press here OK. OK, first we'll have to uncheck here merge solids and press OK. Nice, now we can hide this plane. Select it and hide. And now we'll open another sketch in the second plane. Select the plane, open a sketch, and here we'll have to make the next sketch. First we'll start with the center line. Just make here a center line like this. Then select dynamic mirror entities command, select this center line and select line. And here we'll make the next sketch. Just like this. Okay, now we'll have to select tangent arc. So tangent arc, make here one and here another one. Now we'll select this one with this edge, select here make tangent, do the same with this one, tangent, select these two and make them equal. And now with smart dimension we'll have to define them, but first close this, so select smart dimension and we'll start with these two lines. Here will be 4 millimeters. Between these two will be also 4. And now from this one to this one, here will be 30 millimeters. From this one to this circle, to this center of this circle, here will be 26. And now this is fully defined. Now we'll go to features, we'll use extruded boss base command. And here for the first direction, at direction 1, instead of blind, we'll select up to next. And at direction 2, we'll select also up to next. And we can see that is extruding up to these arms, and press OK. Nice, now we'll have to apply some fillets. So we'll select fillet. First the radius will be 3 millimeters. We'll have to select these edges, this face, this edge, this one, and here also. Sorry, not this face, this edge, this one. Okay, and we'll have to select also this edge with this one and this face with this face with this one and this one. And I think these are all the fillets with radius 3 millimeters. Press here OK. And now we'll have to select another fillet. This time the radius will be 1.5, and with this radius we'll make this edge and this edge. Press here OK. Nice. Now what we'll have to do is to select this face, open a sketch, and here we'll make two circles. So select circle, we'll make one in this center point also, and now with smart dimension we'll have to define them. First, this one will have the diameter 16 millimeters, and make them equal. And now go to features, use extruded cut, and here at blind we'll select through all and press OK. Nice. Now we'll select this face, we'll open another sketch, and here we'll make a circle with the diameter 22 millimeters. So smart dimension, diameter 22, and now go to features, use extruded cut, and here at blind we'll select up to next and press OK. Nice. Now we'll have to open another sketch on this face, normal 2, and here we'll have to select line and we'll make 3 lines just like this. Select this point, this edge, select here coincide, select these 2 lines, make them equal, and now with smart dimension we'll have to define them. So this line here will have 3.2 millimeters and here will be 1.7. Press here OK. Now select line again, we'll have to close this sketch. Now go to features and use extruded cut, and here the dimension can be 18 millimeters or let's make it 20. Press here OK. And now this is the frame. Let's save it. So save it on my desktop. Frame 1, and I'll have to make the next part, which is the pulley. So open any part, let's make this plain white. Here we'll select front plane, we'll open a sketch, and now we'll start with 2 center lines, one horizontal, one vertical, just like this. Then select dynamic mirror entities command, we'll select this center line, and now select line and let's make the next sketch. We'll start from here just like this, and make this horizontal. Okay, horizontal. And now with smart dimension we'll have to define this sketch, and we'll start with this line. Here will be 66 millimeters, this one here will have 63. Okay, and now we'll start with the diameters. We'll start with this, actually now we'll use the radius because we'll use revolved boss base, and We'll start from this line and this center line, and here will be 41 millimeters. Then from this point to the center line, here will be 35 millimeters. And then from this point to this center line, here will be 33 millimeters. And now from this point to the center line, here will be 24 millimeters. And from this one, here will be 22 millimeters. Okay, and now we'll have to give one dimension and here. And here will be 26.9 divided by 2. Okay, and now from this line to this one, here this dimension will be 12 millimeters. And now this is fully defined. Go to Features, use Revolved Boss Base, and we'll have to select this center line and press OK. Now, and this is the pulley, now we'll have to apply some fillets. So, select Fillet command, we'll select here, the radius will be 3 millimeters. We'll select this face with this face. Okay, and this face with this one, and I think these are all the fillets for this pulley. Press it OK, and I'll have to save this one too. So save it, pulley one. Okay, now I'll have to make the next part, which will be the shaft. So open a new part. Now we'll open a sketch in the front plane, and let's make this plane white. Here we start with a center line. Actually, we don't need a center line, let's start with line. We'll start from this point, just like this. Okay, and now we'll have to define it with smart dimension. So select smart dimension, we'll start with this line, the total length will be 134, and then we'll start with this line. Here we'll use also the radius and will be 11 millimeters, and here will be 19 divided by 2, and here will be 8. Okay, and now this line here will have 25, and this one here will have 70, and now this is fully defined. Go to Features and use Revolved Boss Base, and here we'll have to select this line, press it OK. Nice. And now we'll have to make here a hole. So, but first let's open a sketch in the top plane, and here we'll make a point, will help us to place a hole faster with hole wizard. So now we'll have to fully define this point. This dimension here will be 37 millimeters. Okay, and now select this point and this one, and select here make horizontal. Nice, now we'll have to exit this sketch. And now we'll select top plane and normal too. And now we'll select hole wizard. So select hole wizard. Here we'll select hole, ISO drill size, and the size will be 8.3 millimeters. And we'll select here blind. Here the dimension will be 44 millimeters. And now go to positions, select 3D sketch, and first we'll place one here. And let's select these two points and select here, make. And now we'll select these two points and we'll select here, make along X, make along Y axis, sorry. And I will have to place another hole, so select point, we'll place it here on this face, and then we'll select this point with this edge and we'll select here concentric. Nice, and press here OK. Now we can hide this sketch, and I will have to use hole wizard again to make here a fillet, another kind of hole. So go to hole wizard, click on this arrow, select from here advanced hole, and here we'll have to select this one near side top tap. Here we'll have to select this face, and then we'll select here this one. Actually no, here we'll select ISO, here will be this one, here will be 1.8, okay, and we'll have to select here to change here the dimensions. So we'll click on this one, here will be 8.3 millimeters, and here will be, let's say, 10. So here, 8.3. Okay, now go to positions and we'll place it here. Then select this point with this edge and select here concentric. Nice, and press OK. And now we'll have to go here at options, then go to document properties, go to detailing and select from here shaded cosmetic threads. Press here OK. And now we can see the thread. Now let's take a look at the section view. We'll have to select here front plane. Press here OK. Nice. Now we can close this. Okay, and now we'll have to make the fillet on this side. First we'll make a chamfer. So go to this arrow, select from here chamfer. And here the dimension will be 1.5. The angle will be 45. And we'll have to select this edge. Select this edge, press here OK. And now we'll have to make the fillet. So we'll go to hole wizard, we'll select here thread. We'll have to select here blind. Here we'll select the start point, the start edge will be this one. And now here we'll have to select metric die and the size. The size will be M16 and the pitch 2. This one. And now we'll select here offset, so the offset will be 2 millimeters. We'll have to select here reverse the start point, and here the dimension will be 17 millimeters. Press here OK. And now we have the fillet. Now we'll have to do one more thing at this shaft, and this thing is the case it for this wood roof, which is this one, but first we'll have to make the wood roof key. So first we'll make this small part the wood roof key, and then we'll make this slot here. So let's begin. We'll leave this one like this and we'll open a new part. Let's make this plain white. Here we'll select front plane, we'll open a sketch, we'll select center point arc, and we'll make here an arc. The radius will be 6 millimeters, and now we'll make these 3 points horizontal. Now we'll select line and we'll close this sketch. Now go to features, use exploded boss base. Here we'll select mid plane and the thickness will be 3.2 millimeters. Press OK. And now let's save this one. So this one is wood roof. Okay. Okay, one. Save it. And now go back to that shaft. So we'll go back here. And now here we'll have to import that wood roof key to extract it from this shaft. So we'll go to this arrow, we'll go to insert, we'll select from here part, and here we'll select this one, wood roof key, and be sure to have this selected, and here this one, locate part with move and copy feature, and now press here OK. And now we'll have to use mates to place this here. First we'll start with top plane from this wood roof. We'll go to this arrow, we'll select from here top plane, and we'll select here dimension, and here the dimension will be 9.5 millimeters. But we'll have to reverse, so select here flip dimension. Okay, now it's good. Select here add, and now we'll have to select front plane with front plane from the part, from the shaft, and we'll select here coincide, select here, click here add, and now we'll select this face with the right plane from the wood roof, and we'll select here distance, and here the distance will be 11 millimeters, and press here add. Actually it's already added, and now press here OK. And now let's hide, go to this icon, click on this one to hide the planes. And now we'll have to subtract this wood roof from this shaft to remain the slot here. So to do this we'll go to insert, we'll go to features, we'll find here combine command, we'll select it. Here we'll have to select subtract, and now we'll have to select the main body, the body which we want to keep will be the shaft, and here bodies to combine will be the wood roof. And now press here OK. And now we have the slot for this wood roof. Okay. And now we'll have to save this because it's done. This shaft is done. Let's save it. So save it. This is shaft one. Nice. And now we'll have to make the next part. The next part will be the bushing. So let's open a new part. Press OK. Let's make this plane white. Now we'll open a sketch in the front plane, and here we'll make two circles just like this, and now smart dimension will have to define them. This one, the big one, will have 26.9 millimeters in diameter, and the small one will have 19 millimeters. Nice, now go to features, use extruded boss base command. Here at blind we'll select mid plane, and here the dimension will be 63 millimeters. Press here OK. And I will have to make some oil grooves. So first we'll open a sketch on this face, and here we'll select line and we'll make these three lines. Select this point, this edge, and select here coincide. Okay, so coincide. Nice. Now select these two lines and make them equal. And now it's my dimension, we'll have to define this. Here will be 3 millimeters, and here will be the depth 0.8. Now select line again and let's close this sketch. Now go to features, use extruded cut. Here we'll select through all or up to next, is the same. Select through all, press OK. Nice. Now we'll have to open a sketch in the right plane. And here we'll select, we'll go to display style, we'll select hide and lights visible. And now we'll have to start with a center line. Make here a center line, just like this. And now we'll have to select line. Actually here it's okay with line. You can use center rectangle or corner rectangle as well. Nice, and now we'll have to define them. Here will be 8 millimeters. From this line to this edge, here will be 0.8. And from this point to this edge, here will be 10 millimeters. And now we can give here a dimension to be fully defined. Let's make it 2.5 millimeters. And now go to features, use revolved, not this one, use revolved cut. And this center line should be selected here and press OK. Now we'll have to go to this display style again and select first one. Nice, and this bushing is done. Let's save it. Also on my desktop, bushing one. Okay, now we'll have to make the washer. So open a new part. Let's make this plain white. Select front plane. Now here we'll make two circles. Nice, with smart dimension we'll define them. This one, the big one, will have 48 millimeters in diameter. The small one will have 19 millimeters. Now go to features, use extruded boss base. And here the thickness will keep it 2 millimeters. I know that on the drawing is 3 millimeters, but let me explain you why I'm choosing to use 2, because from this face to this other face are 70 millimeters. The dimension from this face to this face is 66 millimeters, so 70 minus 66 is 4. If we'll add 2 of this bushing, one on this side, one on this side, are 3 millimeters plus 3 millimeters, 6 millimeters. 6 plus 66 are 72, not 70 millimeters. So we'll have to use here 2 millimeters, or we'll have to subtract from here 2 millimeters. I prefer to add to subtract from here 1 from this bushing. So it will be 2 millimeters plus 2 millimeters, 4 millimeters, with 66 will be exactly 70 millimeters. So we'll use 2 instead of 3. And here will be 2, press it OK. And now let's save it. So this is the washer 1. Nice, now I'll have to make the hex nut. So open a new part. Let's make this plain white. Let's open a sketch in the front plane. Here we'll select this one, polygon. We'll make here a polygon. Select these two points and make them horizontal. And now it's smart dimension, we'll give a dimension from this line to this one. And here will be 24 millimeters. Nice, now we'll have to make a circle here. This circle will have the diameter 14 millimeters. Nice, now go to features, use extruded boss base command. Here at blind we'll select mid plane and the thickness will be 9. And now we'll have to make the thread inside this hole. So go to hole wizard, select thread. Here we'll have to select this edge. We'll select here offset. Offset will be 2 millimeters. Select here reverse. And now we can keep here blind. We can keep this dimension. Doesn't matter if it's going too far. And here we'll keep metric tap. And the size will be and 16.2 millimeters, which is exactly this one. And now press here OK. Now we have here the thread. Now on the drawing I see a chamfer at 30 degrees, but I don't know the dimension, so select chamfer. We'll keep the dimension 2 millimeters and we'll select, let's see if it's working. No, we'll have to select all of these edges. Press here OK. Actually, sorry, I forgot to change the angle. So go here to edit feature, and here will be 30 degrees. And press OK. Nice. Now we'll have to save it. So save it. This is the hex nut. OK. And now we'll have to make the last part, which is the pin. So we'll open a new part. We'll select here plain white. And now we'll open a sketch in the front plane. Here we'll start with line. So select line. We'll start from this point, just like this. Nice. Now select smart dimension and we'll have to define it. Here will be the total length, will be 38 millimeters. And now here we'll have to use the radius, so it's 11 millimeters. Here will also be the radius and will be 8. And here will be 6. Nice. Here will be 5 millimeters. Here will be 20 millimeters, and now this is fully defined. Go to features and use revolved boss base, and we'll have to select this line. Press OK. And now we'll have to make the fillet first, but first we'll make a chamfer. So select chamfer. We'll select this edge. Here the distance will be 1.5, 45 degrees. And press here OK. And now go to hole wizard and from here we'll select thread. We'll have to select this edge for the start edge. We'll select here also offset, reverse. Here we'll select blind and here will be 12 millimeters and here will be metric die and the size will be M12 and the pitch 1.75. So we'll have to find it. M12 1.75. Nice, and now press here OK. And I'll have to make a fillet on this edge. So select fillet, The radius will be 1.5. Select this face, press OK. Now open a sketch on this face, and here we'll select center rectangle, and we'll make here a rectangle just like this. And now with smart dimension we'll have to give a dimension to this line. Here will be 3 millimeters. Now go to features, use extruded cut, and here the depth will be 1.5. Press OK. And to make the assembly we'll have to go back to bracket. And we'll have to go to the zero file and select here make assembly from part. And now we'll have to select bracket and we'll have to place it. Let's make this plain white. And now we'll go to assembly, insert components, browse, and I'll have to browse for your components. I have all of my components on the desktop, so I'm gonna select all of them except the bracket and select here open. And now we'll have to click once for each of these components to place them. Okay, so first we'll start the assembly of this wood roof with this shaft. So we'll select this face with this one, we'll select here concentric, then this face with this one, and we'll select here coincide. And now we'll have to select this face and select here mate, and then go to this arrow, go to shaft, here is shaft, click on this arrow. And now we'll have to select top plane from the shaft, and we can see that we'll mate that face from the wood roof with the top plane from the shaft, and we'll select here parallel. Press OK. Nice, and now these two are moving together. Okay, now we'll have to assemble the bracket with the frame. So to do this we'll select this edge with this face, and we'll select here concentric. Nice. And then we'll select this face with this one, and we'll select here coincide. Okay, and now we'll have to, let's finish with this side. Now we'll have to add the pins. So select this face with this one, select here concentric, and then we'll select this face with this one, select here coincide. Nice, and now we'll have to make another one of this. So with control pressed, left click, drag it, place it, and then select this face with this one, select here concentric, select here reverse, and now we'll select this face with this one, and should coincide. Nice, and now the frame is added to the bracket. Now we'll have to add this inside this pulley. So select this face with this face, select here concentric, and now to be sure that this is in the middle, we'll have to select this face, select here mate, select, go to advanced mates, go to width. So we have the first face selected. Now we'll have to select this one with this one and this one, and press here OK. Nice. And now we'll select this face with this one, select here concentric, and I'll have to do the same thing to use, actually We can add the washers first. So select this face with this one from the washer, select here concentric, then this face with this one should coincide. Now we have to move this, okay, just like this, perfect. Now we'll select this face with the face from the washer and select here coincide. Nice, and now we'll have to add one more washer on this side. So with control pressed, left click, drag it, and now we'll select this face with this one, select here coincide, and then select this face with this one and select here concentric. Nice. And now we'll have to insert the shaft. So to insert the shaft, we'll select this face with this one, we'll select here concentric. Nice. Now we'll have to drag it out. Now we'll have to select this face from the Woodruff key and this face from the bracket and select here coincide. Nice. And now we'll have to select this face with this one and select here also coincide. Okay, and now if we want to take a look inside, right click on this frame and select here change transparency. And now we can see the key roof here, it's fitting perfect. Now change the transparency back. Okay, now we'll have to add this hex nut. So drag it here. And now to add this, we'll have to make it to be concentric with this shaft. So for this we'll have to go to this icon, this eye, select this line, and then we'll select here view temporary axis, and we'll select this axis, this X with this one, and select here coincide. And now select this face with this one and select here also coincide. And now go back here, select this one to hide the axis. And this is the assembly for this belt tightener. This is the tutorial for today. Thank you for watching, and if you like it, you can leave a like, you can subscribe if you want to see more. And I hope to see you in the next tutorial.